What's up, y'all? It's your boy Gerald. Sunday, 16, January 2022, part two. How is everybody doing? So, I had to make some coffee. And, you know, I wanted to express this this message to the intended heart, intended mind. If this finds you, it is meant for you to hear. And if you've never been to my channel, my name is Gerald Davis. I've had this channel since 2011. And 22 is about you. But first and foremost, you may hear some music in the background. I've got YouTube on. And with that being said, this is protected by Section 107 of the Fair Use Act. All rights and entitlements to YouTube, Google, the entertainment, such as the artist labels, that the proprietorship solely is entitled to. This is also going to be used as a means of inspiration. However, this is for educational and critique use only. No monetization shall be required, because it's all about connection. So, the first video I put out, how you doing? Doing all right? I hope so. I really, really do. I woke up this morning, family, had my little beer going, and, you know, I'm starting to get frustrated because you guys have been riding with me for a little bit. And from those that have been riding with me from day one, thank you, thank you, thank you. You're the reason why I do it, because the whole goal is for you to have the best life possible. Why? Because you were made perfect. Come on now. Why would you expect anything less? So, I wake up this morning, take Ming out, give thanks to be alive. And then I'm grinding up my coffee beans, and I'm making my pot of coffee. And this whole dialogue of this video spawned from a conversation I had with my significant other, which, because of an epiphany of thoughts and feelings that I had been underlining processing, because I, like you, the mind doesn't rest. It's always trying to move the pieces so that it all fits collectively. And just as I made my first video about 2022, you know, I had to sit back and look at what was being offered collectively across not only the algorithms, but social media and the platforms that is represented. And me, I can only be me. Let me let you know this. Everything conveyed comes from the Most High, the one of many names. It is spoken as no different as if because I don't write anything down. I speak from the heart, and I walk it like I talk it. So, looking at the narrative of what's being interpreted in social media, and I spoke on this almost 3 years ago, when I had these videos out called A Divided House Can't Stand. And I talked about how the importance of what your foundation is being built off of is a direct reflection of your state of mind. And some people understood. Some people wanted me to expound, but the fact that it reached the intended heart and the intended mind. Because at the end of the day, the whole reason why you exist is because, one, you were a spiritual being first. Two, before you took your first breath, there was a covenant spoken over your life. And that covenant is what's going to fulfill your purpose, which is really nothing but your identity, your character, your self-worth. All these things are intertwined to make you. So why are we in 2022 still expecting a certain outlook or outcome without having transparency to have the discussion that's needed? So what do you mean, Gerald? Society has always moved on a pivot. As the elders would say, pressure busts the pipes. But what's the pressure? Truth. So, what is required? Until you understand what's required, can you actually envision it to act on it? And it seems like society has force-fed the impressionable to embrace an ideal or ideology of faking it to make it. Why? Because 85% of it is fear-based. If I want this, but I have no understanding on how to accomplish it, what's going to happen? I'm going to start to be in my head. I'm going to start to overthink. I'm going to miscalculate. I'm going to miss the mark. And we're wondering why we live in a world where half of the populace suffer from mental illness. Mind you, I've been speaking on mental illness and mental health, the importance of identifying your state of being since 2011, because that was the reason, through personal experiences, of why this YouTube channel exists. Because you're looking at a man for over 20 plus years, almost 25, who's trying to figure it out. And in process of that journey, I literally was blessed to travel the world by way of serving my country with honor and dignity. But still, the desire to come to understand who that little boy was inside me. Why was I attracted to this and drawn to that, when in actuality, I was trying to fill that void inside? But we don't have these discussions these days. Why? Because it is too easy for society to put labels on you, call you weak, kick you when you're down. And then, unfortunately, when things turn stark, when things become tragic, we're quick to deflect, let go, and not take ownership. Who am I talking to now? I'm here to tell you, family, wherever you are right now, you still have a whole lot of life to live. You have people that are connected to you now, and people you have yet to come to know, that are reliant on you to be healthy emotionally, spiritually. These are things that will define and display what your purpose is all about. So, does it surprise you, the narrative that has been displayed is based off of the world? You gotta have this to obtain that. You gotta be able to do that to get this. But why is it there no dialogue and discussion on cultivating the person that's going to do the work? Because to do that, that means you also have to acknowledge what makes your environment. Now, I'm not going to sit up here and assume that everybody has the perfect life, because that's not the world we live in. Some of you have had trials and tribulations that are unmentionable. And then on the flip side, some of you have gone through things that no one would be able to understand or have the ability to walk in your shoes. Who am I talking to? But see, because the devil's work's not done, and for those that know the purpose of the devil is to kill, steal, and destroy. Destroy what? Your lineage, your legacy, your purpose. Why? Because the moment that you took your first breath, he knew that you were going to be the vessel that may bear the child from you, that may change the world. Why? Because everybody's given natural talents and gifts that comes with you. And as if you haven't, and I kind of mentioned that in the video prior to this, so if you haven't seen it, if you got time, click on that. Better yet, just cut it on and put it on in the back, turn it up, and just listen to what I got to say. You know what I'm saying? Because see, at the end of the day, all I ever wanted when it comes to my legacy is to be the influence that you too can have heaven on earth, to have the dream life that you've earned, because the seeds you sow is the harvest you reap. Who am I talking to? So, talking to my significant other, and in that dialogue, it caused me to look back at my life. And I saw some things that were pretty alarming. And first of all, this is not to be disrespectful, because the one thing about life, not everybody's going to be able to understand you, but they'll be able to have a commonality of your experience. So, if you're going through something right now, or you're doing the work, this may be validation of the seeds that you're planting. First, I'm going to put it on pause for a second before I go there, because I'm speaking to you from here. You know, it seems very convenient now to move the algorithm. It must have drama. It must have suspense. It must have intrigue. It has nothing to do with empowerment. Why? Because it would put a major dent in the social construct. And then we all know that there are people that don't want you to think for yourself. Come on. Come on. Think about it. We're coming from an era where you were taught to learn the phone numbers of those that were significant in your life. The things that will be required for you to learn independence. These, you know, some of y'all would call that latchkey kids and stuff like that. But if you ask the common Joe right now, hey, what's that loved one's number? 9 times out of 10, They can't tell you. Why? Because we're not using the only 6% of our brain like we should. We've gotten too relaxed. We've allowed our lives to be placed on autopilot because it's inconvenience. It's convenient. It's the convenience of having tech. But tech is nothing but a tool. You could have all the tech that you want, but it won't make that hurt go away, now will it? Who am I talking to? But what's so ironic, you know, I remember saying this in conversation. I said, how is it in today's era, at a click, a swipe, and in real time, you can connect to your loved ones. But we were more closer when we didn't have that. And you were reliant to a phone call, a letter, even word of mouth. What happened? They said the more advanced we got, the values on the things that should matter, such as family, those that we break bread with, our community, they've taken a back seat, haven't they? Which is sad. So, let me go back to my points. Because I know that some of you feel a certain kind of way. You looked at the year to come, and you had that conversation with yourself. I congratulate you on that because it was long overdue. And in the process, some of you may have taken it a step further and wrote down your thoughts, because I'm going to tell you something. There's a power when it comes to writing your thoughts down that can be almost surgically cleansing to the soul. Why? Because you can't argue with words. But what it will do is require you to be transparent, to find truth. Who am I talking to? So some of y'all got a brand new attitude. And it's not because of a position of contempt or a position of selfishness. No, this is time that you're going to roll up your sleeves. And the reason why you're rolling up your sleeves, because now what is empowering you is the selflessness that has been there the whole time. So what I mean by the selflessness, that means you're ready to cultivate you. Some of you are finally allowing yourself to give yourself permission to get back to the things that you truly enjoy doing. Your passions. You know what passions are? That's the things that you love so much you would do it for free because you find enjoyment out of the experience. Some of y'all may turn that into another form of therapy. Who am I talking to? Because I'm going to tell you what, family, unfortunately, you're going to have some that they've already convinced themselves it's too late. And I'm here to tell you, as long as you can hear my voice, as long as you can breathe that air, you got time. As I mentioned all the time, I remember one of the questions placed on my heart when I was at my lowest level. And it was, can a man be made new? And I remember that was the moment that I actually embraced my spirituality. And I caught some ridicule. I did. I had people tell me that I was being obsessed. But really what they didn't know is I was determined to find myself within myself. Yeah, I even had people distance themselves. Like, oh, you're on this spiritual stuff again. But you know what? That's okay, because everybody's road is different. And I always would echo this all the time. my two favorite poets. One was John Frost. He made the poem "The Road Less Traveled." If you've never read it, go to your search engine. And then the other was by James Baldwin, and it was kind of like a haiku a little bit too, but it was called "Love Is a Battle." Love is a battle. Love is about scars. Love is about growing up. And it's so much, that is so heavy, you know, and because that was an expression of his truth. And if you know James Baldwin's backstory, that's so many layers in itself. So, some of y'all have a call, you have a calling to yourself. I want to say a call to arms almost. And you're like, you know what? Instantly, you can look back 5 years and you see where you are. And you're looking at where you are today. And you're looking at the transitional time of what has changed compared to what has not. And some of y'all may have felt frozen. Some of you may have felt numb. Some of you may have felt emotionally disconnected. I think 2022 is the year that you're going to turn around and you're going to look at, actually put voice to what that was. And you're not doing it for your environment, you're doing it for yourself. And I commend you for it because it's a long time overdue. And you deserve it. You deserve it. You truly deserve it. That's the neighbor's dog. But on the flip side, the mindset of fake it to make it is not going to work no more. Some of y'all have gotten to a point where you're like, I can't carry that burden no more. Especially when you've been scratching your head the whole time saying, this wasn't my burden to begin with. And guess what? Some of y'all are like this. I'm tired of feeling like a bird with wings that I can't soar. But I think it was T.D. Jakes. I think he coined a phrase. He said, if you have a chicken mentality, but you were born an eagle, how can you expect to fly? Or something like that. And it's the truth, because it's your mindset. Your mindset is going to set up your attitude of your direction. But how are you going to do that? How are you going to do that? You must first identify what don't work. And for some, that could be very, very fearful. I always use the term, misery is an endless table filled with endless chairs waiting for you to sit down, because when you decide to sit down, that is when life stops. You can't do that. Because meanwhile, the folks in the cheap seats, they're laughing. They're finding enjoyment. Some of y'all may be related to them. Some of y'all may know them from the job. Some of y'all just may know them by circumstance, because life is about choice. And the one thing about life is we attract what we are. Who am I talking to? So what are you going to do about it? What are you going to do about it? You going to stay the course? Or are you going to take ownership and say, you know what? Even if you weren't the proverbial culprit, you still had a role to play, because we teach people how we want to be treated. But if you don't understand who you are, how can you dictate the behavior you're going to receive? Some of us call that being a martyr. Some maybe know that as being a glutton for punishment. But in actuality, you're carrying the weight of your heart because all you want to do is do right. And that's why I really believe society convinced you, queen, when they told you, oh, you don't need a man. You don't need a man. But also told you, what a man can do, you can do yourself. Well, this is what they didn't tell you. Equality is across the board because, yes, you're a human being. But what they don't tell you is, it's called being an adult. Why we don't talk about that? See, the bread ain't buttered on both sides. But they want you to believe you can have your cake and eat it too. Does everybody have to pull their weight? You're goddamn right they do. You're damn right they do. Hold that thought. So, here's what I'm alluding to. How can we talk about the social responsibility as a community when we don't have the foundation as an individual? Because last time I checked, there are, 7.3 billion people on this planet? Well, guess what? 50% of them were not prepared because of economic, emotional access. So that is why you're seeing a division economically across the board, because of the fact that you have men and women that were not properly prepared to be adults. So that is why you got that guy that's acting like he's 13, but he's 50. Or that woman that's trying to claim years past, or worse, you have our babies rushing to be old because they think they're missing out if they don't put themselves a part of the mix, but actually indirectly they're putting themselves at harm because they're not emotionally prepared on what life requires. But why don't we talk about that? See, right now everything is about the financial aspect, the financial back end, and we're focusing on the fact of what the relationship construct is. Listen, I'm like this. You can have access to anything you want, but if it does not make you feel emotionally safe, it's a waste. You know, just as I always say, what does a millionaire and a homeless person have in common? They don't. Can the homeless person be inspired by the wealthy? Yes. But guess what? What about the action? What about the transition of how that person became that? But when you focus on the materialism, guess what happens? You compromise the emotional. Who am I talking to? And then you're wondering why self-respect is being ransomed by materialism. I remember I used this this analogy some time ago. I talked about the designer shirt, and I'm going to paraphrase it because I can't remember it per se verbatim, but being the fact that I had the pleasure of working in retail 17 years of my life, so learning how to deal with the physical interaction of a customer, I learned that, you know, and I actually loved the interaction between, you know, sender, receiver, consumer, the customer, the seller, you know, I learned that. And, you know, that still has a reflection on the emotion, because if a person understands the emotional triggers, they can dictate the financial outcome, especially if they are very scrupulous. Because from a retail standpoint, what is your bottom line? Financial gain, commission. You want to close the deal. So let's flip it for the emotional. What is the end goal? For you to be happy, to have the best life. Well, how can you understand what is required, what is needed to illustrate that if you don't understand you? Who am I talking to? Now let's go ahead and flip it to a little darker. Does it surprise you why we have more focus on your sexuality these last 10 years than your intellect? Why are we not talking about that? People would rather want to know what you look like under this than what you got to say from here. Why? And then you wonder why people in the on the away team say, I don't want you messing with them. Or better yet, you want to keep the advantage? Put it in a book. They're going to leave it alone. They're afraid of it. That's their kryptonite. But then on the flip side, tell you, queen, that's why you don't need him. Do it on your own. And the stats show it. The stats show it. At, you know, intellectually, you surpass your male counterpart. But does it surprise you? Because when you match up male to female, the female automatically has a 7-year advantage because of that was how you were born. That's why, and as I mentioned before, you are given 2 spiritual gifts. The gift of nurturement, the gift of discernment. And that's why society does not want you to tap into either one. Why? Because they want you to have the consumer mindset. They want you to continue to consume. And what is that? Embrace gluttony, one of the 7 deadly sins. Why? Because they know what comes from you will also be impacted. Talking about your children. Your children. Whatever they see mom do, they're going to mimic it because they're going to swear that's gospel. So, but what if mommy has been disconnected from the little girl inside? Why don't we talk about that? That means your offspring are already at a disadvantage. Why? Because you set the template. How does that pertain to boys? It's the same with girls. If they don't have a positive influence, they're going to turn and gravitate to what they interpret that illustration should be. So, if they're not receiving attention, love, support, structure, they're going to gravitate to whatever is demonstrating it, even if it's negative. Think about it. Why do you think gangs exist? Why do you think the drug pandemic? We don't talk about that pandemic, do we? We talk about what's going on, but we don't talk about what's been going on. Come on. So you got all these deflectors out there. When you gonna get back to you? So let me dig deeper. Let's talk about your friendships. I've always echoed this. Your friends are a reflection of your state of mind. So if your daily interactions looks like something found on a social media platform, I guarantee what's not there is self-respect. Let that sink in. Because your bonds, your friendships, should be a direct reflection of what you value most cognitively. But see, society don't want you to do that. Society wants you to burn yourself out. Society don't respect you. Society wants you to disrespect yourself with your own duty not to take accountability of what was put out there to be consumed. Think about it. First, you know, I remember the, you know, because whatever the narrative is, commercialism will match it. Why? Because it's the capitalism, it's the capitalistic mindset. Whatever is the hot topic, you're going to have seven to ten people trying to profit from it. Why? Because that is the opportunistic mindset. But at what cost? So some of y'all are like this. I gotta cut people off. I'm glad you woke up to that. Because I know you were terrified to do it. But here's the sad truth about that. Those people that you had given access to for whatever amount of period of time, they'd already cut you off already. And that's why they have, that's what I call light switch people. You know, just like the light switch, cut it on, cut it off. They only give you energy when it's something that benefits them, not what you need. So some of y'all are saying, well, listen, I'm tired of holding the rope. I'm tired of holding the bag. It's time that I go it alone. Okay. That's why they call it a spiritual reset. You may know it as a sabbatical. But just make sure the reason for it is for you. What do you think forgiveness is all about? You think forgiveness is for the people? No. Forgiveness is for you so that you could validate what you identify, address what needs to be identified, and release what needs to be. Because if that was the case, imagine all the people that you've come to know and trying to carry those said bonds. But on the flip side, imagine the relief you would have knowing the truth. And see, that's the sad thing. We don't talk about the stuff we should, because that would save you 50% of impulse and effort to those that shouldn't be invested in. And here's the sad thing about that too, because sometimes people will stir. Let me tell you something. The more and more you focus on you, the more clarity you will have around you. Who am I talking to? That's why when things of importance come up, there's only a select few you can have that dialogue with, as well as access. Why? Because the person knows that sooner or later it's going to come up. And they don't want to have that conversation. Maybe because they haven't mastered themselves, or it will force them to do something different. And that means change. Think about it. So I commend you, because some of y'all are going to come into your greatest image of yourself. Now I'm going to tell you, while you're doing this work, you need to stay prayed up. You need to make sure that you are methodical in your choices. That's why, as I always say, there's a beautiful word called no. If the energy is not balanced, leave it where it is. Keep it moving. Why? Because they're not thinking about you. They're not. And they don't have the integrity to tell you that. Now, some of y'all might be in relationships, and you're like, well, you know, we balance each other out. Your relationship is not a wheelbarrow. You know a wheelbarrow? That means you got that one wheel, and you're carrying it. But the whole objective is to balance, to make movement. No. I think some of y'all, 50% of y'all gonna do this. Some of y'all gonna be saying, hey, look here, we need to sit down and talk about this. If they're not willing to, out of respect, hear what you got to say, Don't take it personal. That's just validation of what you should have been doing. Think about it. Because I mean, guess what? Some of y'all thinking, well, you know, some of y'all have relationships that were soul ties. Yeah, they were. That person was brought into your life because of what you lacked to know, but their whole intent was to hold you back from you. If it's not amicable across the board, that ain't a relationship. And it's not respected either. I know some of y'all be like, well, you don't understand because our sex life is great. There's a difference between sex life and happiness. How's that? Because the sex life is nothing but action, which is temporary. Happiness requires investment, but it leaves you fulfilled. It makes you feel emotionally safe. If you can't truly be vulnerable in your environment, that's an environment that you should have never been in. So, let's talk about the social media narrative. You have everybody talking about the financial, but never nothing about the emotional. How can you talk about the emotional when you don't have an identity of self? If you don't know what love looks like for yourself, how can you preserve it through your partner? And queen, let me tell you something too. Because society is all about this Jezebel spirit. And if you don't know about the story of Jezebel, I highly recommend you go up there and read it and tell me you don't see the nuances of how it's being played out. Why? They don't want you to have a spiritual connection with yourself. Because as long as you keep a spiritual, as long as you don't, the more influence you'll be. Do you realize that? And you're wondering why there is a plummet in birth rate. You do know the birth rate globally has gone down tremendously. Even though they try to tell you, no, there was more babies because of what was going on. That's far from the truth. You got more people that are sterile because of choices made. So, well, let's sidestep that. Because that might end up being your testimony if you do the work. But see, that's the problem with society. Society wants to put you in a box so that they can benefit off of you economically. Think about it. First, they took prayer out of school. Then they took the Pledge of Allegiance out. Then they changed it up, brought it back, and with some additions. So how can you have loyalty to where I'm not trying to make light of it. How can you pledge anything if you're not willing to pledge to yourself? Hello? They don't hear me. No. So, guess what? You go on any platform right now, and you got somebody titillating to the eye, and she thinks she winning. But little did you know, is unless you own the platform, that's not your property anymore. So guess what? You leaving intellectual property for your generation to see in real time. Why we don't talk about that? Because society doesn't own the internet. Only proprietorship has it. Be careful what you do. Why? Because they offer it as free will. Why? Because they want to be able to diversify ways to make money off of you for free. And we all know the Joneses, keeping up with the Joneses, don't exist. But as long as you keep focusing on the things that don't matter, the outcome will be the same. Lost, alienated, bitter. But why we don't have those conversations? So, some of y'all are gonna reassess your bonds now. Let's talk about economics. Anything that's overnight don't last. So whatever you decide to invest in, make sure it's a representation of you. Because what's here today doesn't mean it's going to be here tomorrow. But your digital blueprint will be. Think about that. Now, Queens, there's a lot of people on this mission to define who they are based off of their economics. If that person does not have a relationship with his spirituality first, she will never have a relationship with you. Do understand that, right? Because materialism is exactly what it is. You can't take it with you. And having said access financially is exactly what it is. It just opens another door. But even Biggie Smalls said it best, more money, more problems. How do you navigate through that? Place God first in everything you do. Because if you do that, guess what's going to kick in? Your discernment. And it's going to empower you to sidestep that negative. Because what everything that's good is not good for you. But it's hoping that you will. And look what happened with Eve. She got misled. And look at what, it's the domino effect. But here's the thing though. Until you're willing to walk it, don't talk it. Because you got a lot of discord online these days. And it's never about the dialogue of what matters. And we're going through a trajectory change now where that is going to be reassessed. And pretty much, like your elders say, watch what comes out your mouth. Be careful what you wish for. Because you energy out is energy return. So what you going to do? Now, I commend those. I will say this, too. Some of y'all are waking up with the mindset of, hey, look here. All the things that I genuinely enjoy doing, you're going to focus on that. And that is going to actually produce fruit of your passions. And guess what? The world's been waiting on that. Been waiting for you. You know, all it takes is one person to spark change. You know what I'm saying? Because listen, looks fade. They do. And let me tell you something, Queen. The person that you were in the mirror when you had insecurity was the most, that was when you were at your best. You don't have to do that. You don't. Because what you're going to see is this. Just as there was a mass exodus that continues to this day to augment. Now, I understand you go do you, but what does your health say? What does your health say? Because until there is a medical way to alter your DNA, you're still the same person. But what can be changed is the mindset. You change your mindset, you can change anything. But to change it means you have to identify what's being presented and make a decision if it's accepted. Who am I talking to? So don't get mad. Don't get mad that you don't hear from them. Give them the same energy that was invested. Because trust and believe, they probably like, I can't believe this person's on this. And they hoping that it's just a phase. And they hoping that you'll come back around, or you'll drop your guard and they'll say, welcome back. Don't do that. Keep it moving. Keep it moving. Keep it moving. Keep it moving. Because just like artists of the group Floor Tree, I always say that, Natalie Stewart, she had a song called Breathe. If you've never heard it, go right up there in the search engine, type in Breathe by Natalie Stewart. Listen to her words, because she was all about, she was a poet first, spoken word. But listen to that song. And I guarantee you, when you do, that little boy, little girl is going to be like, thank you. That's a classic that didn't get claimed. But the intended know it, because it's true. Now, I know some of y'all, I'm going to bring this home. Some of y'all live, breathe the desire for a relationship. Do yourself a favor. Prepare for them. Don't go looking for them. Don't. That's the worst mistake you could do. Take this time to work on yourself, to be the best you can be. And guess what happens? The Most High sees all, knows all, and if the work has been done, they'll be revealed to you. And you'll know. You'll be at the point y'all be able to, you'll both be able to finish each other's sentences, because you'll be in sync. Two is one. But if you allow your physicality to jade your perspective, you're doing yourself a disservice. And I get it. You get heated passions and stuff, but the best form of chemistry is found right here. And right here. That's what intimacy is. Because it also tells you exactly if they're worthy. And so don't trip. Don't feel pressured. Mm-mm. That's just like somebody that wants the grocery bags but don't want to pay for the bill. Nah, but don't get it twisted. The two shall be one. That means you got to do your part too. And does it surprise you? Now there is pushback because you have people saying, well, hey, I'm right here. I've got options. But society's been telling you, queen, you deserve to be there too. But guess what they don't say? Is the work amicable? No matter what the economic, you know what I'm saying? Why we don't talk about that? Which goes back to what I said. What does the wealthy and the homeless got to talk about? They don't. They don't. Flip side is this. If you marginalize it on the physical, nobody wins. But the wear and tear will live on you forever. Meanwhile, they laughing. I got more for less. Why are you doing that? Mm-mm. You're not missing out. Just like that teenager that want to be at the party. You're not missing out because you're not there. Sometimes you're being protected of what's going to be found there. Think about it. How many times you hear stories of people being put in harm's way because they put themselves where they should have never been? Or better yet, didn't have the conversation to give themselves the right to make the right choice. I'm just saying, I commend each and every one of you for making this step in your life. It is long overdue. Like I said, don't trip on stuff that don't grow. Don't, because they ain't tripping on you. But they will miss you. Oh, trust and believe. They probably watching. You, come on now, that's what people in the cheap seats do. You know, but don't bash. Wish them well, keep it moving. As long as you keep it moving, you keep it growing. Take ownership, take stock in your life. Love to hear from you. Give me a thumbs up or give me a thumbs down. But if you have any questions or concerns, inbox me. Your privacy is always paramount. Also, if any of my videos can be used, that you may have somebody that may need to hear it, share my stuff, share my content. Lastly, before I go, people might ask me, what's going on with Patreon? I got a Patreon account. I do. There's no content on there because I'm deliberately holding out. Also, I'm going to start editing my videos, and I got some other stuff I'm not going to reveal yet. So, as well as I have a Vimeo, I got a... the last thing I got to do is set up my StreamYard account, and I got to do one more thing. But I'm on social media. I'm on Instagram. I'm on Facebook. Some of y'all already know that, because some of y'all probably, you already know. You know, it is what it is. But just know, I place God first in everything I do. Because my journey is to have the best life and legacy. And you know what? Before I go, because I think somebody needs to hear this. Stop tripping off your kids. Somebody need to hear that. Stop tripping on your kids. So what do you mean, Gerald? Some of y'all, listen. I don't care if you're half blind and only got one ear. A true parent wants the best for their children or child. But it's the child's responsibility to want to receive. If they're not ready, guess what? Acknowledge it. Be optimistic. Continue to love them, even if it requires you to love them from afar. I said that. Why? Because it's not worth your emotional health and well-being, because they're going to be whoever they're going to be. And I get it, because some of y'all are like, well, you know, you want to protect them. Listen, people come into your life for a reason and a season as well, because you may be in a situation where it's a co-parent situation, or there's bias going on, and it's and the effects of said environment. Guess what? As long as you got integrity, nothing changes. But until they are able to respect who you are, what you stand for, let them figure it out. Let them figure it out. Do not take that personal, because whatever the influence, at the end of the day, they will realize the time they wasted. Why? Because you're blessed.